Songs since I was 18. Apologize if I say anything I don't mean.
Like, what's up with your best friends? We get out, have some fun, believe me. And what's up with these friends?
Yeah. No new friends. But get it how you get it, y'all.
Cause all that hype don't feel the same next year, boy. Yeah, and I'll be right here in my spot with a little more cash than I already got. Tripping off you cause you had your shot. With my skin tan and my hair long, my fans who been so patient. Me and 40 back to work, but we still smell like a vacation. Hate your rumors, hate these stupid allegations. I'm just feeling like the throne is for the taking.
Watch me tell you. All I care about is money and the city that I'm from.
I'm gonna take that back. I care about myself.
Until it's done, I don't really give my excuses that I'm young and I'm only getting old.
Somebody should have told you I'm on one. Bump it, I'm on one.
Yeah, I said I'm on one.
Word.
Yeah, I'm on one.
All right, y'all, for the copyright, man, I just had to start it off with that, man. Drake, Wayne, DJ Khaled, Ross. Oh, man, on one today, y'all. Good morning, good morning. You too. What's going on, y'all? KB the smooth one. Y'all know what it is. Hi. You know what I do. Glory to God. Praise to the Most High for waking all of us up today, man. You on winning team? Keep that man first, the Father in heaven, man. You know, believe or not believe, that's your choice. Bow now, bow later. All I'm going to say is one day we all shall bow. Let's get it right, get right. What's going on, y'all? Oh, man. I'm still in the hotel, as you can see. Waiting on my finance company to approve the repairs. That's why you got to keep your maintenance up, man. If I had the full amount in my maintenance account, I'd be Gucci. But I just, y'all know the story, just got my truck out the shop 2 weeks ago, man. So, put $3,500 in it. Now I'm putting another $2,600. But it's going to be well worth it, I pray and hope, man. You know, this girl hold up. This be the last major repair for this wintertime. You know what I'm saying? Outside, I got a PM doing another 10,000 miles. And check my tires and brakes and all my air hoses and cooling hoses. You know, let's get it. Let's get our vehicles ready for the winter, y'all. But let's get into it. This video is going to be Dart Transit, lease, OPI fleet, addressing some things, man. I've been a lot of people been hit me up, and I've been seeing videos from other drivers, former drivers that been with Dart just in the recent year, 6 months to a year, and a lot of people getting confused. And even in my videos, I believe sometimes I do go off topic. I apologize, but this video I'm gonna try to stay all on top. But this is about Dart lease program, OPI fleet, booking your own loads, moving yourself. No dispatcher. You have a fleet manager, but you dispatch yourself. So let's get into it, y'all. So y'all know I've been at Dart Transit going on 4 years now. It'll be 4 years to the Zach next year. Yeah. I started out as a company driver. I was on the TJ Maxx Marshall's account, dedicated regional account. Got me. It was guaranteed to get me home on the weekend. 5 days out, 2 days off, that was the guarantee. You run your 70 clock, do a 34, you back out. You know what I'm saying? And it was touch freight. You get three stops per trailer. You pick up out of Bridgewater, Virginia. And I ran that sucker. Like I said, I'm still on top of about the lease. But then I became a lease driver in 2019. June, to be exact. The black truck y'all see in my videos, the 2016 Freightliner Cascadia, it had 390, I believe, 4 miles on it, right before 400,000. I currently have 597,000 miles on my truck. Yeah, she about to trip six. So since I had her, I'd have put over 200,000 miles, going on 300,000 miles, because let's see, 390, that's four. Yeah, let me do the math real quick. Yeah, so 200 and pretty much 90,000, 97,000, so almost 300,000 miles on my truck. Not too shabby, man, for going on the third year leasing that girl, man. But y'all know she also been put me through the ringer, as I mean, as far as in the pocket, as far as maintenance, getting her up. But what am I doing to the truck is, it's not no knock against Dart. Any company you go and you lease a used truck, you're going to have to put some money into it. You're going to have to rewrite the wrongs of the first driver, a second driver. Like, I'm the third driver in this truck that I'm currently leasing. So, yes, you could say Dart should have took care of it more better. And, you know, some of the things should have been caught before I got the truck. But for one, a lot of drivers don't take pride in their job. They don't care about the truck, even if they're leasing. They're just so focused on the money that they're just running the truck ragged. They don't give a damn, do the bare minimum just to keep it up. And that's what I believe the guy did before me, because there's a lot of stuff that should have been corrected that he probably either overlooked or didn't care about, because he was just running the truck, the dog crap out of it, trying to get money. So I'm correcting all that now. About to put another 26 in it, dev system issues and stuff. And yeah, so, but OPI fleet. Okay, let's get into it. So Dart has three options on leasing over here. You have the mileage fleet, you have the percentage fleet, which is the 65% fleet, and then you have the OPI percentage board fleet, which is open percentage, I guess independent, but basically open percentage board fleet. That's the fleet I'm on. There's a waiting list to get on that at Dart, and they actually want you to run a regular percentage for a certain amount of time. I believe is up to 6 months. It may be longer. Right now, they don't want to put too many more drivers on the OPI fleet, because a lot of drivers ain't ready for this open board dispatching themselves, especially if you've been a company driver or you've been at outfits where you've been always having a dispatcher your whole career. So the OPI fleet is kind of like a lead thing. It's kind of like a, yeah, like a top status. Like, you got to be on your game, driver over here. And Dart looks at that, man. They'll do a review of how you run and how you've been doing loads and making sure you're making them on time and this and that and the third. And they're gonna ask you, are you ready for this booking yourself? Do you feel comfortable booking yourself and keep yourself moving? You know, and some drivers jump into it because they see drivers like myself or other drivers on it, and they want that freedom of, yeah, man, I want to go where I want to go and do this and that. Then they get over here and FUBAR it. You know what I'm saying? They get themselves into a world of hurt, or they mess it up for the other drivers, man, dropping loads and all kind of foolishness, man. So, but basically, that's how it breaks down the three options you have over here. But mainly the first two, until you get some time in the Dart. And then if you're doing up to par and above and beyond, they'll come to you and probably, like I said, ask you about the OPI fleet. But right now, I'm going to tell you, anybody coming in the Dart, you ain't getting on the OPI fleet. There's a wait list right now, man. They say there's up to 90 days on something on this wait list right now to get on OPI. Trust me, one of my partners has been at Dart over 12 years, and he's elite driver over here, and he's on the waiting list. He's number 30 to get on OPI. That's how serious it is over here. So, but the OPI fleet is an open percentage board fleet. Basically, you get to book yourselves, and let's get it corrected. You can negotiate the rate to an extent. To an extent now. Most of the time, the rates are kind of set, you know what I'm saying? And I'm going to tell you, I'm going to break it down some of the boards that we do. So let me jump on this tablet real quick. Let me go home. Okay, so let me see if y'all can see that. Y'all see that? Comment in below. You see that? I'm looking at the screen. I think y'all can see that. So that's pretty much, and that's just the cream of the crop. We got like mad low boards. I say like 30, 40. I don't know. It's a lot. They email us every day and give us a list of more low boards we can get on. But these are the main ones I freak with. And these are the main ones that I've been making money over here with. So you see that got Coyote Go, Uber Freight. We got Snyder Power, JB Hunt 360, XPO Drive, Trucking Tools. We got Navis Spear Carry, which is C.H. Robinson. And yeah. So that's the ones I freak with. So, and let me see. Can I log on? Let me see. I'm going to show y'all the Uber Freight real quick. This is the quickest one. Uber Freight is one of the easiest low boards. And I say when you come over here to OPI, oh, yeah, because I got it logged in on my phone, too. It's wanting me to log in. I'm not going to give y'all my information right now. But y'all that been running on the low board, I tell y'all, y'all know about Uber Freight. Now, I'm going to explain something about Uber Freight. Uber Freight is a hit or miss. Uber Freight, you got to pick and choose your battle wisely. And what I can say about that, they have it now where you got a bidding. It's bidding on the app. where you can bid on the loads. What they offer on the loads, they'll have bid. But I'm going to be real with y'all. Uber Freight ain't coming off no more than $400-$500 more than they put on there. Sometimes only $200 or $300 more than what they already rate on there. I'm just being real. And then once they counter your bid, that's pretty much either accept it or go on about your business. That's all they're going to do. They're going to give you one counter offer. That's it. Now, Coyote, they actually a little bit better. Coyote Go, they actually a little bit better. These cats right here, they actually a little better. Now, you can go on there and negotiate your rates really good on here. You can counter lows. Yeah, see, all these things going to log in because I'm logged in on my phone. So, they don't want you logged in on two devices. I can log in on two devices, but right now, like I said, I ain't going to give y'all all my info. But Coyote will give you the load, and you can counter it as many times as you want. But eventually, it's going to pan out. It's going to be like, hey, this is all the max you can get, and take it or leave it too. But you can actually recounter the load. They'll send you a rate. You counter it. They send you back what they offer, then you can recounter that, and it's like a back and forth for a minute. But you don't, like I said, pretty much some of the rates are fixed, but so you can counter. And with Dart, you know, we got a good rapport with most of these brokers that we get to book it now, meaning we can see the price of the load and all that, and all the information, we can book it now. That becomes, for us, getting lows on time, having a good rapport with that broker, man, making sure we're getting the freight on time, pickup and delivery, and we stay within a certain percentage of what they standards are. And a lot of them are right at 85 and above, and they want you at 90, pretty much 90 to 95 percent, definitely on pickup. Delivery, they want you almost 100%, but they don't want you no lower than 90%, and they don't want you no you can't be within 15% of the late, meaning dropping loads within the 6-hour period. So that's how it's working. And then you can call them. We have Dart Pacific representatives with these brokers, man. Like with Coyote, I got Kylie, Jared, and Zach. With Uber, Uber is a little different. It's a lot of foreigners on there. They are Americans, but Uber has direct contacts with Dart too, depending on the load and where and the customer. That's how Uber works. So it's numerous to tell you who would on there. I know I got Michael, Sarah, Susanna. There's a couple on there. Now with Snyder Power Board over here, we deal with Carrie, XBO, I forgot. Yep, and then the ones I didn't show y'all, we got Molo Logistics with Jason. He's the main contact rep. And then we got Echo. I forgot to show y'all Echo. Echo Lowe's on there. And that's Chad. Chad's the man. You know what I'm saying? So, and then Navispear, C.H. Robertson, my man Nick. Nick, he my man over there, contact over there. So, don't get it construed. There's some drivers that saying you can't negotiate over here. You can, but it's to an extent. It's not like... what is it? It's not like the DAT board. It's not like the agents. Like, you know, if you got a BOA and you're over there at Landstar or Great Wide, like, you can really, you know, really, really, really negotiate, you know what I'm saying, and tell these cats the load. But you know what I'm saying? So that's kind of, you kind of put into kind of a little bit far as, you know, the money. But I make decent money over here. A lot of these loads, they pay decent. And like I said, we get a book it now advantage and stuff. So, you know, it's working for me. I'm still learning this game, y'all. So you can take it how you want it, man. You know what I'm saying? Y'all can say I'm still micromanaging. I'm still under control. Every company, you still have delusion like you run everything. But no, they give you to the extent, but you still under their authority. You still got to follow their rules. Keep within their safety guidelines and all that. But as far as the load boards, that's pretty much how it break down. You get on there, and I'm going to tell y'all my philosophy. I try to book loads between Monday and Friday. You know, yeah, you can book loads on the weekend, but the best loads are going to be while they're in office doing normal business hours, man. But it's usually 7 to 5, no matter what time zone you're in, 7 to 5, they use the office hours, man. Most of these brokers are in Central Time, by the way, just so y'all know that. So that's an hour behind East Coast time. So I'm from the East Coast. So you want to try to get your lows. And also, I'm going to tell you, too, just starting out, learning, no matter where you at and what load board, don't pitch yourself no more than 3 max lows at one time. Because I'm going to tell you why. You get yourself stacked up with 3, 4, 5 lows, right? let's say the first one works out good. You deliver, you pick up, deliver, no issues with your truck and trailer. You get there, you boom, boom, you get the second load. That sort of works out good. You might have a short delay at the shipper, but you can still make the delivery time. Now, the third load is FUBAR. Or no, let's say the second load is FUBAR. That load, you got some delay or some catastrophic thing happened with your truck or whatever. Now, there's no possible way you can make that time on the third load. Now you got to call the broker and basically cancel that load, and that's what they don't like. Now, if you do it within 48 hours, even they say 24 hours, usually they not too bad and give them the reason why. But they really don't like you dropping loads once you lock it in. Once, because Dart bills them. What they do is they call it a bill system. Once you book it, you send the Raycon in to a percentage over here, percentage@dart.net. And what they do, they will build the load, meaning they will figure it out, do Dart's calculation, and they'll send it back to your Qualcomm as a pre-plan. It's called workflow. They'll send it back as a pre-plan. And you can accept it then, you know, which you already should accept it because you booked it. But look at the Raycon. Look at your, when you get your pre-pan and you get the Dart, whatchamacallit, where they do their thing. They do their Raycon. They do their rates and all that. And they tell you the mileage, load, and all that. Make sure everything's correct. Make sure you get that paid. Oh, and on the OPI fleet, 70% of the long haul, 70% of that, you know what I'm saying? So, Dart takes 30%, you get the rest. You get 70%. That's on the OPI fleet. Now, on the regular percentage, it's 65%. Dart takes 35%. You don't have to pay trailer fees over here. You don't have no rental, no none. You're not even responsible for the trailer at all. I mean, you are responsible for letting Dart know and keeping up with your trailer like it's yours. But as far as paying out of pocket for anything that goes wrong with the trailer, Dart take care of that. So that's one advantage I like over here. That's an umbrella that I like until I'm ready to buy or purchase my own trailer. You know, I know at Landstar and most other places, you have to rent like F2F. And because I know drivers over there, you have to pay a rental fee a week, I think. A couple hundred bucks a week just for the trailer. So here you don't pay nothing for the trailer. You just got to keep up with it though, and you keep the same trailer on the OPI fleet. You know, on the percentage fleet, you can do if you get on the Dart Advantage loads, blue, purple, red, green, orange, you can get in some of our direct shippers at Dart, like Lowe's, Procter Gamble, Georgia Pacific, Walmart, and all that. We could drop and hook at our customers. But over here at the OPI, you pretty much whatever trailer you find, that's going to be your trailer locked in unless you get authorization from your fleet manager and they talk to, you know, they talk to the customer. It's one of our customers that we allow to interchange agreement to drop the trailer on the yard. But pretty much I've been keeping this same trailer I got out there, 480455. I don't have that for the last, what, 3-4 months after I got rid of that other trailer down in Texas. Yeah. So, but that's how it works over there. So it's live load and unload on the open board. So you basically, one truck, one trailer operation, live load and unload when you doing the OPI fleet. That's how you get down. And I know a lot of drivers don't agree with that, but that's why you got to pick and choose your battle wisely. And also on the OPI fleet, even the percentage fleet, your deadhead is free, meaning you got to book accordingly because your deadhead miles, you're not paying that. So you got to factor that in when you're booking the load. You got to factor in your deadhead miles. So the load may be paying $250 a mile, but if you're deadheading 300 miles, and the loaded miles is only paying 600, that's a 900 mile load. You got to calculate that in with the load and your fuel. That 250 dropped down to probably what, 185, maybe even 150, you know. So you got to look at that, drivers. You got to, you know, you got to stay strategically. And that's one thing I like about Uber and Coyote. They give you backhauls. Before you even book a load, you can look at reloads like on Uber and Coyote, because I freak with them a lot. You can look at reloads and... So before you even book a load, you can see where you're going, what they got available on the same broker there. And sometimes you can book twice, you know, book a load at the same time, like book one load and then book another load. So, you know, you guarantee not to be stuck at that place, you know. And the way I move my business is I try to book a load within 5 hours. I say minimum 5 hours, give you time just in case that receiver pussyfooting around and you get stuck. So you don't want to book too tight. Like some drivers book an hour out, 2 hours out. You ain't getting out. The average you getting out these shippers and receivers is a minimum 2 hours. I give myself a minimum 2 hours, just like they do on the detention. I give myself a minimum 2 hours So that way, you have time to get unloaded and get to the next place. So you don't want to book yourself that tight. So I book myself 5 hours out when I deliver. You know what I mean? Unless it just works out where there's a shipper, I deliver at the receiver, and then the next shipper is either at the same place or right down the street within 20 miles or 30, 40 miles. You feel me? And that's all about you running your business on that aspect. I'm just telling you how KB does it. Y'all do y'all business that way. So I'm 20 minutes in. I think that's pretty much covered most of it. Any questions, concerns? I'm back in the game. I'm back, you know, checking my social media, checking my YouTube, checking my email. Feel free to reach out to me. I'll put my email in the description, and I'll throw it out there to those that comment and ask for it, you know. You come with some bull stuff, and I'm going to put you in spam and block you. That's just real. If you serious inquiries only about Dart Transit and how I am over here. You know what I mean? I'm not promoting Dart. I'm not telling you to come over here. Nor have I ever told you to come to any company I ever put out here. But Dart is working for me. It is a decent company. It ain't the greatest. They got their cons too. You know, I'm not going to get into that on this video. But there's not one perfect trucking company out here. Don't worry. If you find one, don't worry. I'll wait. Let me know where they at so I can peep it out. But Dart, we do our thing over here, man. We kind of undercover. You know what I'm saying? We drive like a boss. We get our settlements on time. You see the human picture on the back of our trailers, man. But we do our thing over here, man. So I'm in it to win it, get this truck paid off, get the title in hand, get my maintenance caught up. So, you know, and then I'll make a decision then whether to stay or move on. But right now, I'm all right. I'm all right where I'm at. You know what I mean? So that's the breakdown of the open percentage load board. The mileage I don't deal with because I'm not on mileage over here, but I know it's $1.05 to $1.15 a mile depending on the count. 95-cent deadhead, 50-cent coming out of home time, and that's about it. So, but I can get the information for you. See, that's the thing with me. I may not know everything, but I can go, I know people that know people, and I can, and within this company, and I can get it for you. So just feel free to reach out to your brother. And yeah, I am a one truck operation, and I am busy too, getting my game back up. Damn, they calling and interrupting my damn video. Oh well, they had to leave a voicemail. But anyway, I'm about to wrap this up anyway. So any questions, I can explain more by talking to you in person. Or we email each other first, and I make sure you real and make sure you sincere and you serious about this thing before I waste my time and energy out here, y'all. I learned that too long time ago when I started helping people and stuff, man. You can't help everybody, man. But y'all be easy, be breezy. Remember my family out here, your family. Let's stay safe. Let's stay healthy. Get our health right first. Look at here. These are my pre-vitamins, my vitamins. Got a T booster. This is like a pre-workout nitrous oxide for your heart. Get your heart up. I drink my nutritional shake. And I know this ain't that good, but it's sugar-free. The Coca-Cola energy with coffee. I freak with that. And water. I stay hydrated, man. And I like this core pH balance. They say these pH 7 waters is better for your body to absorb. And the Garcinia Cambogia, Dr. Oz was telling me about this. It helps speed up your metabolism and curb your appetite so you can help you lose weight. You know what I mean? And just try to eat better, man. Lower my carbs, keep my protein up, and keep my good fats up, man. So health is wealth. If you ain't got no health, you ain't going to get no money out here. And let's stop so much focusing on the money. And let's stop counting other people's pocket. You know, what's the sell and what another person does doesn't, you know, what they say, what another person eat doesn't make you poop. Yeah, so stop counting these other people money, man. That's just my advice. I don't know that much, but KB, I try to give y'all a jewel or two, man. If y'all take it. If you throw it away, throw it away. But I got to get going. I'm going to check on my truck today. Hopefully, I get some news that they got it worked on and maybe even be back ride. Maybe my next video, y'all see me and my girl again. So y'all be easy. Love y'all. Thank y'all for all that watched the full video. Any more questions, like I said, feel free to reach out, man. KB be here, man. If I don't go with you, I'll try to get back to you as soon as possible, man. Y'all be good. God bless. I love y'all. Peace.